welcome to Metal Gear Solid 5, a game with enemies that are somehow terrifying, yet dangerous, yet inviting, all at the same time.
I've got a big, big thirst for human blood!
And just to be completely upfront with you, I've never played a Metal Gear Solid game before this one. And like one of my buddies so eloquently told me, playing a Metal Gear game for the first time is a lot like walking into a strip club for the first time. No matter how much you act like you've been there before and you are brand new, everybody can tell that you have no idea what you're doing. So I'm not gonna try to lie to you. All I'm asking for is a little bit of slack, because I happen to be a casual babby novice status when it comes to the series in general. And because this game takes like 30 to 35 hours to complete, which is pretty long when you take into account that the average Call of Duty game only takes like what? 6 hours, 7 maybe, if you're like blasted drunk, you can understand that it's a tremendous amount of gameplay and content, so it's a little overwhelming. It's almost like I was sitting on a couch reading Diabetic Desserts magazine, and then all of a sudden Kojima popped out of nowhere, threw a waffle the size of a swimming pool in my face, and started hosing me down with syrup. It's like, this is too much. I can't. No. Please. No. I need an adult. No. The game starts out with you waking from a 9-year coma in an unnamed hospital, and wouldn't you know it, everyone's trying to kill you, including this chick, who happens to be an extremely well-trained assassin, yet she doesn't know how to stop, drop, and roll. I'm not even joking when I say the first hour of the game is basically you crawling around on the ground like a snake and trying to escape said hospital with a guy named Ishmael, which is pretty dumb when you think about it. Like, really, guy? I've been in a coma for 9 years, I no longer have one of my arms, and you aren't even gonna help me out with a shoulder to lean on? Oh, okay, I guess I'll just be squirming my way out of here then. Your wiggling journey is interrupted by this guy, the Human Torch, who looks really terrifying until you find out his major weakness. Yeah, I don't know why, but he's just really susceptible to getting run over. I don't know what his deal is. There's also some other gas mask wearing chick with a jacket that's like 8 sizes too big for her that somehow tosses a fire whale at you, and then the Human Torch starts chasing you on a flying unicorn made of flames. I feel like I missed some plot points here. Am I missing something? And then you actually get to start fooling around in the desert with missions that don't involve you squirming around a hospital like some sort of slug. Now, the first thing you gotta know about is the Fulton recovery device.
It's a Fulton recovery device.
Long story short, if you want anything in the game, return to your home called Mother Base, just attach this thing to it and it will zip it right back to your HQ.
That's the thing, comrade.
Subject on board. The rest of us.
And basically anything you can tranquilize, you can kidnap, which includes enemy soldiers, prisoners, and even animals. Like, yeah, you can send back dogs, wolves, sheep, donkeys, and even bears back to base. But I must caution you, I would tread lightly when it comes to bears, because the bears are a little terrifying.
Well, somebody stop the damn man! Enough, enough! You can't do this, Kenny!
You gotta be kidding me!
Don't do this!
I do find it hilarious, though, that you can actually do that. I mean, think about it. Imagine being the guy that has to take receipt of all these animals back at base. Like, what? Is that a bear? Why did he send a live bear? What the f- Now, I know you're wondering where exactly all of these things go, and it's quite simple, really. You have this headquarters called Mother Base in the middle of the ocean that you can expand upon and build out as if this is some kind of oil platform simulator. It's pretty neat. From this HQ, you can expand your army by kidnapping random soldiers from Afghanistan and forcing them to become your personal mercenaries. And as an added bonus, it gives you a rundown at the end of the mission what their names are and what they're good at when they join your army. And I gotta tell you, some of these names are just... what? You crying crab, greedy armadillo, dizzy octopus, cannibal hippo, crying iguana, stubborn rooster, and blazing gator? Anytime you go on a mission, all you really need is a horse, a helicopter, and a cardboard box. The helicopter is pretty handy in taking you wherever you want to go if you learn how to use your iDroid correctly, which I recommend that you do, and the horse is pretty damn fast and somehow invincible. Like, you can get absolutely littered with bullets. The horse can appear to die, yet if you whistle 20 seconds later... I mean, sure, there are other modes of transportation like cars and tanks, but most of the time, I hop out of those and end up using the horse anyways.
First, let me hop out the motherfucking horse. I don't want it if that ass don't seem like a horse.
Really? All you need is the cardboard box. Yeah, you can literally just run around in a cardboard box, which is just as fun as it sounds. But the real fun starts once you throw some posters on top of it and make the enemy think you're someone else. Like, you can even throw a poster of a girl sitting on a bed of roses on the side, so when enemies spot you and you go prone, they all run over to you and stare. You can do the same thing to the front of the box with a glamour model. So as long as you stand still when you get spotted, enemies will drop their weapons and you'll have a free headshot with your tranquilizer pistol anytime you want.
What you say?
Now, if you're having a hard time being stealthy, feel free to be a casual and equip the chicken hat from the options menu. This chicken hat will basically give you 3 free passes when it comes to getting spotted by enemies. They'll just start laughing at you and let you path unscathed.
Deactivating stealth assist.
There's even a baby chicken hat if you're really that bad, which I really hope that none of you are that casual. Personally, I find it best to use the chicken hat in combination with the cardboard box.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Now, some stuff in the game, you just have to accept as being weird and go with it. Like, some of the missions are just, yeah, this is some kind of Japanese translation that sounds off. For example, there's a mission called Where Do the Bees Sleep?
That shit is fucking trash, dog.
You can tell that Kojima probably just threw that into Google Translate and said, yeah, whatever, that sounds like a legit military operation. Mixtapes are another thing that I found a little morbid. Like, you can literally listen to mixtapes while you're sitting in the chopper.
Okay, it's challenge, give me no hunger, throbbing like the NASDAQ. Move white girls like this coat up my ass crack. Move black girls, cause man, fuck it, I'll do either. I love pussy, I love bitches, dude, I should be running meter.
And just so you know, it's a good idea to visit Mother Base every once in a while, just to keep the morale of your troops up. Even if it means just bumping into them and them saying boss, boss, boss over and over again, they'll love you for it.
What's up, boss?
Boss!
Boss.
Boss. Boss. Boss. Boss. Boss.
Heavy combat is pretty self-explanatory. I think the most hilarious thing is when you sustain a serious injury and everything starts moving in slow motion. It's pretty neat.
Boss, that's a serious injury. It won't heal on its own. You'll need to treat it with first aid.
The only two characters that I really enjoyed seeing were Kaz and that random sniper chick. Like, Kojima made the reuniting with Kaz pretty dramatic when he puts the shades on. Damn. And oh yeah, that sniper chick. She's the same girl that doesn't know how to stop, drop, and roll from earlier. Fighting her is the silliest endeavor ever. Like, first of all, she seems to always be in an extremely high place that you can't reach.
Get the fuck down from there!
And to add on to that, anytime you do get close, she just immediately jumps away and vanishes into thin air.
Don't fucking run away from me! I'll end you!
But if you hit her enough times in the face with a rocket launcher, you can take her down. Then you're smacked with a difficult decision.
My mind's telling me no, but my body... My body's telling me yes.
Having her around isn't terrible. I mean, her outfit looks like she went to Stripper's Discount Warehouse and picked off the clearance rack, so it's not the worst thing in the world to have her on your screen, and she somehow manages to quickscope a fighter pilot and agrees to be your prisoner, even though she's some kind of ghost demon lady that can move through walls? So I totally recommend having her I'm totally kidding. I blew her into like a million pieces with plastic explosives.
It's over. Good.
And that's about it. I'll let you figure out the rest for yourself. This guy is not that spooky, by the way. He's like 3 out of 10 would not spooky.